You know, it's funny to me that I'm sitting here making this video because I literally just got done recording and editing a Yu-Gi-Oh! Video for tomorrow, which now is going to get pushed to the next day. Because honestly, I didn't think I was going to make any Dragon Ball Legends related content this week. Because let's be real, we had an LF that just dropped, we had a Ultra actually that dropped, and then prior to that we had an LF. And honestly, I was thinking to myself, like, there's nothing hype that's going to come out right now, at least until the anniversary, that's going to be like worth really going into. But, come on. It's like Toshi knew that I was getting bored of the game, and he was like, you know what? Hit the Rhyme Styles getting bored button and drop a new Whis and a Golden Frieza. Are you kidding me, Toshi? Bro, both of these guys are amazing. And not only that, but the Whis, which you guys know I love playing Beerus, Whis is perfect with Beerus number one, and two, he has a brand new mechanic that's called Obscure, which basically flips all your cards face down. So you're playing kind of blindly. It's like, what is happening? Can we skip this? This is going to be trash. Trash. First one's trash. So yeah, they're switching up some abilities that makes it, you know, it's going to add, sprinkle in some interest into it that makes me really, really excited to play actively again. And when I say actively, I don't mean like nonstop like I used to day one. I'm just talking about this going to be stuff that's going to make me want to come back and play PvP here and there until I get annoyed and then I go play Yu-Gi-Oh! Again or something else. I don't really know. But Legends is in a weird spot for me because, like, I honestly am just kind of tired of gacha games in general. And not that I'm saying I'm going to quit Legends. I still enjoy Legends. I definitely want to play it a lot less. The whole playing it as often as I used to is not going to happen anymore. I can't. I don't think I can do it. You know, being able to hop on here every single day and make, like, a Legends video is just... I'm good. Even doing it once a week, I'm like, I'm kind of good on that. What we got? Nothing. Is that the original... It is. The green Goku from like forever ago. Oh my god. If that card ever gets to Zenkai, you guys are going to have issues with it. The thing is that card... Nothing. That card is pretty ass. And with how tame the Zenkais have been, even if that guy got a Zenkai and upgrade stats, he will be a problem because of that counter. It will be insane. But anyways, side point. Point is my love for gachas has been... Well, let's be real. I never really had a love for gachas. The only gacha game that I really was fully into was Hunter x Hunter Battle All-Star, and that game obviously got shut down. And I saw what happens when a gacha game shuts down. And two, you know, I played a lot of Dokkan, and that Dokkan over the years just kind of got pretty boring to me because you can only play a game for so long. At least with Legends, there's a lot of gameplay aspects behind it. But end of the day, it's still a gacha, and summoning for a new unit every, like, what, 2-3-ish weeks, it does get redundant, especially when... you end up not pulling what you're seeking. Now, for me, I got lucky. I've actually managed to pull everything that came out in the game. But I'm never going to get to that point, and it might be even today, where a banner drops, you know, and then I just don't get the new units, and I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to pursue it. I'm good. I'm great. Nappa! I actually can use that because I didn't really summon for that when it came out. But yeah, let me know where you guys stand with gachas in general down below. You know, like I said, for me, I've been more about just wanting to play other stuff that brings me a lot of joy. And right now, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is just so fun. I have fallen into this pit of Yu-Gi-Oh! That I just can't get out of, and I don't even want to get out of it. It's like, you know when somebody has an addiction, and they're like, I can quit whenever I want to, I just don't want to? That's me with that game. And the great part is, I get to make content around it, so it's like a plus. It's like a win-win situation, so it's like, I got nothing to lose on. So yeah, but I also want to do more stuff with Legends in general. I think the thing about Legends is there's so much Legends content out there that it's like, by the time I even get around to making any videos around it, there's already like 85,000 videos of that certain thing. Like, I'll tell you right now, by the time I hit end record on this video, not even upload, but end record, YouTube is going to be flooded with, you know, showcases, summon videos, all that stuff. That's just the nature of gacha content. I'm not going to post... Nice. I'm not going to post any PvP content at least until tomorrow, and that's a maybe. That's still a I might not even do a content around Frieza and Whis just because I don't think people really care that much. If you do care, you know, you can let me know by hitting that thumbs up on this video. I'm not even going to say a like goal. I'm going to just say if you enjoy the content and you want to see PvP with the new units, like the video and leave a comment. And then if the interaction is strong, which I feel like is going to be kind of average because this is kind of like a random release, then I'll do it. If not, then I'm probably just going to drop Yu-Gi-Oh! The next day and then call it because that's just a... I don't know. I'm just kind of like kind of going with the flow with what works best on YouTube and what people want to see the most. And right now, luckily for me, it's a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh! Content, which I'm perfectly okay with. What we got? We got the instant transmission Kamehameha. And no sign of Whis or Golden Frieza. Good news is, because it is a all-star banner, if I do happen to pull this, number one, I have a lot of multi-Z powers I can use. And two, I can also just buy right out from the shop, like, what, 2,000 crystals to get, like, plus 1,200 or something like that, which would be perfect with PvP. So, At least All-Star banners give you that clutch, you know, along with it. These have been ass summons. What happened? Everything's been like from like forever. Why that lag? Like briefly lagged it for a second. And then we got an old Goku. I think this is what probably kills me the most right here with gachas and why I don't enjoy summoning is when you keep seeing units from like years ago that you pulled a lot and they just keep happening. Like right now, the only new unit I pulled out like what, 5,000 crystals was the Nappa. Not to say that, you know, I don't have everything maxed out, but like usually everything that has popped up has been old from like year one, which is kind of crazy. Let's skip this because I feel like this is going to be trash. And look at that, I was right. But hey, we got something that can be kind of used. Just no one really uses these angels, nor would that be even be viable. All right, let's get right into the next one. We're going to hop right back in. Ideally, as I always say, if I can pull one of each right now, spend the remainder of the crystals in the shop, and then we'll see if I can walk away with, you know, at least like the basic stats so you can hop into PvP. But yeah, I think like the old gacha novelty to me is just falling off. How do you guys feel about that? Because like, what's always crazy to me is to see how many people play gachas in a daily, but not just a gacha, but several. Like, there's people who hop on here and they'll play like 85. Like, look at that. This is from before. This is literally year one. Granted, I think the last slot, the guaranteed slot, is always something older from my experience. But yeah. But like, going back to what I was saying, it's just people that play so many gachas throughout the day, and I'm just like, how? They're usually very grind heavy, number one. And two, they can get expensive. This might slap. This summon right here might slap. This summon might slap. Question is, do we get granted what we want here? We got an Outer Breath Frieza. We got punched a little too hard in the sternum. What happened? What gonna happen? What happened? What happened? Come on. We're not gonna skip this one because we want to see both Whis and or Frieza pop up. Come on. I don't know which one I want the most. Comment section below. What do you guys prefer the most between Whis and Frieza? I feel like everyone's going to say Whis because he's a new card and like a new playstyle. And the obscure feature. But Golden Frieza, so cool. What we got? Hey, we got the Whis. Whis-san. That's what I'm talking about. Great. So we at least can do a Whis PvP video. Oh, that would have been so hot. If I got him back to back, that would have been so hot. We can at least do a Whis PvP video in the next day or so. But again, let's see if people want it. Like I said, the Legends PvP always kind of tends to do a lot worse performance-wise and reach-wise than the summons. Because I feel like by the time I even get around to doing it, because I'm not going to do a frame one when the video and the banners drop. I'm good. By the time I get around doing it, there's so much already in search and nobody really even cares. That's just how I see it. But again, it's going to be up to y'all. If y'all want to see it, you can just leave a like in the video and a comment. And I'll do it probably the next day. If not, we'll just do Yu-Gi-Oh! Because Yu-Gi-Oh's cool too, and I got a pretty fun deck that I've been messing around with in the past week. We got Mercenary Tao. So we got the Nimbus and we got Tao back to back. Let's see if I can walk away with Frieza right now. Although Tao just guarantees spark and doesn't mean anything special. Although I feel like Tao and the Nimbus should be the same thing. Tao and Nimbus should absolutely be the same thing. Is it 3? Nope, this is going to be random. Do I like this one rock? Let's skip it, because I feel like this is going to be trash. I was right, trash. And look, Dispo! Granted, he's kind of newer, but still, I'm so tired of seeing Dispo and Topo as well. At that point, the question is, I think I'd rather see something old at that point, because at least I can make fun of it, because it's like, this is from like 4 years ago in the game. Ooh. You know what? Let's see if I was right. Ah, come on. But that was a lot of sparkings. What we get? We got Goku Black and Zamasu, which is nice. And outside that, we got Launch and the Vegeta from like year one. Okay, we're kind of getting close to the end. Ideally, if I was to pull Frieza right now, with Vegeta popping in, it'd be kind of iconic. We can end the video, it'll be a short one. Because then all I gotta do is hop in and then buy the packs and then play and then basically unlock the missions to get the Z powers and call it a day. Because again, there's no reason to pursue units like this. Cool. Awesome. Vegeta really came in and just gave himself another unit of himself. Alright, we're gonna get one with sparking at least at the last slot, but most likely it's gonna be something cool. Let's see if I can call it. I'm gonna say year one Goku. There's a lot of units, so to kind of call it correctly, it would be difficult. But let's say year one Goku. Something that came out in the first year, Goku. Raditz! Okay, so I was way off. Close, kind of, but way off. Not even really close, just his brother. All right, so we're going to hop into the last 4,000 territory right now. See where it goes, but mostly what I want to do with this video is just kind of talk about my, I guess my thoughts, to see where you guys stand with the Legends content in general, and just gotchas. Because, you know, I stream all the time, and I talk about gacha games, well, we usually poke fun at them. And I feel like people who watch the streams will have, like, a general similar consensus. But this is the YouTube side of things. So I don't know, like, if people are still super interested in gacha games and are heavily playing them. I do know the popularity of games, like, just always go down and down and down and down. So, let me know where you stand! And based on, like I said, what you guys say, I'll decide what I'm going to do with PvP and more Legends, like, content in the next day or so. Maybe I can try to figure out another way to do it. Because, you know, something I liked, what I really enjoyed was how, like, me and Dotto did the PvP videos a while back, because that was fun. Gohan, awesome. Let's just skip, because I am expecting that. There's the year one Goku. I was one away. Okay, last three multis. I think I'm gonna start skipping if I see no fancy animations like that. It's definitely skip worthy. And look at that, I was right. Majin Vegeta, we got Merge Zamasu, and was it 18? Yeah, this is great. This is why I don't want to pursue new units like that in these games. All right, last two multis. Maybe let these rock run in space. Always love to see that. It's always a good sign, at least in my opinion. Although it means literally nothing, but it's in my opinion, it's a good sign to see a different kind of scenery, rather than always being on like green Namek with just five pods and then getting nothing. Remember, I think in Dokkan, it's always annoying me the most is when I would pull nothing. Not only would I pull nothing, but I would always get like no background, like no animations at all. It would just be Goku flying. I'm like, can you at least bring in your friends and maybe think you're gonna get something? Like, come on, man. Fake out!
Surprise, motherfucker.
Into the boy! The Golden Frieza, that's what I'm talking about, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Ooh, that art is sick. That art is insane. We faked out into that. I'm happy about that. Now the question is, no, I'm not doing it. I was gonna say, do I, no, I'm not doing it. I'm spending the last 2,000 crystals I have on probably Whis. You know what? Come on. It's just kidding. It's the last 1,000. Let's just do one more multi and call it a day. But at least I got both of them unlocked, so I can at least try to get them to what, six stars through the power of the shop. And we're gonna walk away with this. Great game. Great. That's fine. I got the two cards I needed. I'm good to go. And we're going to end the video right here. But comment section below. It's going to be a quickie over here. Let me know what you guys want in regards to the PvP content. And again, if you really want it, I'll do it. If not, I'm just going to probably do Yu-Gi-Oh! The next day, because it's more entertaining. It reaches more people. And more people want to see if that makes sense. With Legends, like I said, by the time I get around to doing PvP video, there's so many videos out there that it's like the algorithm just buries it. And I feel like people just don't care as much. So let me know what you want, and I got you. But as always, thank you guys for watching. My name is Rhymestyle. I'll see you guys in the comment section below. Peace.